Grade 6 Math, number 2.4b. Divide a decimal by a whole number. The previous video, 2.4a, is a video of showing all the decimal operations of dividing by a whole number, dividing by a decimal, dividing a decimal by a whole number, dividing a decimal by a decimal, and it's all on one board so that you can see all at once what's going on. So if you're interested, you might want to go back and check out 2.4a, all right? I don't know if you remember from last year, but the quotient is on the top, the dividend is the big guy that we're trying to divide, and the 3 is the divisor, it's the little guy on the outside that's going into the dividend, and we always put our decimal point straight up into the quotient, okay? All right, when we use models, all we have to do is make as many models as the dividend is. We have 2 and 50 hundredths, or 2 and 5 tenths. So what I did was I made 2 whole ones. I made 5 bars of 10, and then I cut one of them in half when I got near the end because I had to do a 5, okay? But I ended up with 1 and 2 tens and a 5 for each side, which is 1 and 25 hundredths, see? So to do it the long division way, we ask ourselves how many times can 2 fit into 2, and it's 1. So we put our 1 directly above the 2, and we do our 2 times 1, which is 2, and we do our subtraction, and it's 0. And now it's the 5's turn to come down. 2 goes into 5 2 times. We put the 2 up here above the 5, because that's what we're dividing into. 2 times 2 is 4. We do our subtraction and get 1, and now it's the 0's turn to come down. So our answer is going to go above the 0. 2 goes into 10 5 times. We put it right there above the 0. We multiply it by the 5 and get 10 and have a 0 remainder. All right? So when you try making your own models, you really, really should, because they're easy to make. See? You can just draw lines on your school paper and make a flat thing of 100 units or a long of 10 or single ones. You can color them or leave them white to color them as you're doing the problem, because that helps, when, especially for the dividing decimals. You can color them in for each problem. But the reason why it's good to use models is it's one thing to know what you're doing with the numbers. It's another reason thing to know why you're doing it. If I said, do you know why 2 hundredths divided by, you know, 125 thousandths is, you know, an answer? Do you understand what's going on with those two fractions or decimals? So that's why using the models, it really helps you visualize and see what's actually happening. Okay. If we have 8 and 56 hundredths and we want to divide it by 2, we ask ourselves how many times can 2 fit into 8? And the answer is 4. So we put our 4 up here above the 8 because that's what we were dividing into. And we do our multiplication, we get 0, and we put our decimal point up there, which we can actually put before we even start doing the math problem, because we know it's going to go straight up, right? So now it's the 5's turn to come down, and we ask ourselves how many times 2 can go into 5. Well, 2 times 2 is 4, so we put our 2 above the 5, because that's what we're dividing into. And we get a 1 left over, and it's the 6's turn to come down. How many 2's can fit into 16? Well, 8. That's perfect. 2 times 8 is 16. We do our subtraction, get 0. And then, to make sure we did it correctly, what we do is we check by multiplying. We multiply the 4.28 quotient by the divisor. And if it comes out as the same number as the dividend, which it did, we count the hops, see, to make sure the decimal point's in the right place, then we know we got the right answer. Okay, for this one, we're doing 1.732 divided by 4. So we ask if 4 can fit into 1. Well, no, it can't. It doesn't fit into 1. It's too little. So we've got our decimal point straight up. Can 4 fit into 17? Yeah, because 4 times 4 is 16. So that's why the 4 is going above the 7, because we're fitting it into the 17, not the 1. See? So we do our multiplication. We put it down there, do our subtraction, and 17 minus 16 is 1. Now it's the 3's turn to come down. 4 goes into 13 3 times. See how it goes directly above the 3 because that's what we're dividing? And then that's 12. 4 times 3 is 12. We get 1 left over. It's the 2's turn to come down. And now we have 12 again. We put our 3 up there. We do our subtraction and get 0. And then, again, we multiply the quotient by the divisor. And if it comes out as 1.732, it does, then we know we did it correctly. And see, we counted the hops coming over. There were three hops. So at three hops in the equation, there's three hops in the product. And we know we did it right. Okay? All right, what about for a bigger one? We ask ourselves, if six can fit into four? Of course not. That's way too small. But it can fit into 43, because 6 times 7 is 42. So we put our 42 down there and do our subtraction, and we get a 1. We can put our decimal point directly above, and now it's the 9's turn to come down. 6 goes into 19 three times, because 6 times 3 is 18. We do our subtraction, we get 1 left over. It's the 6's turn to come down. How many 6's fit into 16? 2. Because 6 times 2 is 12. So we do our subtraction, we've got 4 left over, and now it's the 2's turn to come down. How many 6's fit into 42? 7. So we do 6 times 7 is 42. We do our subtraction, get 0. See? And then, of course, to check, we use inverse operation, because the inverse of division is multiplication. And we multiply the quotient to the divisor, and we count how many hops are over in the quotient, and that's how many are going to be in the product, the divisor. And if they match, we know we did them correctly. See? It's not that hard to divide a decimal by a whole number. It's just like regular division, and it's really no big deal. Okay? You could do this. This isn't that hard. I'll see you next video. Bye.